Now, there is extension of the problem. Again, we are discussing second case for components subject to the complete reverse stress for finite life. This is second type. Finite life problem. The life of the component is specified. Last time discussed for infinite life, let us go for finite life problem. In this case, the components subject to the complete reverse stress in finite life problem. SN curve is a guideline. What is a guideline? For components operating with the complete resistance. How it is drawn here? This is SN curve is valid for steel only. So this is a log to the base 10 of applied stress on y axis and log to the base 10 of number of stress cycle on the x axis. Okay, now you have to plot the graph, the coordinates of point A. Point A, coordinates of point A is the number 3, comma, log to the base 10 of point 9 of SVD. First state. So this is a 3 or log to the base 10 of 10 raised to 3. So this is a 3. So the first point. Now then coordinates of point B is 6 comma log to the base 10 of endurance time. So somewhere here 3, 4, 5 and the 6. So this is the coordinates. So this is a point A and this is a point B. And draw this line, a straight line and extend onwards. So coordinates of point B will be 6 comma log to the base of applied stress. And this is one nothing but log to the base 10 of endurance strength part that particular component. And here I have to determine the life of the component. So what you take on y axis, you take the coordinates n. Okay, you have determined life n and erect vertical line. So like this, intersecting on line AB at F. Okay, and from the point F, draw line parallel to the abscess curve. Intersecting point, suppose this point is a E and this point you call as a D. So we get the straight line AB and beyond AB, B onwards, whatever the number of stress cycles are to come subject to the our compound not going to fail. So this point, coordinates of point B, that is known as the inverse state of the actual compound. And you have to determine the life of the compound of any applied stress. So this is a erect any line from the unit. So like the compound is given for you, here vertical line from here, intersecting line AB at F, and from that draw in parallel to the abscess curve until point E. So this value gives, point E gives, it is a 3 comma log to the base 10 of applied stress for which the component is subjected to. Okay, so make use of this diagram, you have to determine the life of the component. For that, because the similar triangle, from the single triangle, that is AEF and ADB. From the single triangle, you mark the graph of AE by AD is equal to EF by BD. What is the AEF? So this is a, so this is a log to the base 10 of 0.9 of SUD minus log to the base 10 of applied stress, this is a SF you call, divided by AD. What is the AD? This is a, again, log to the base 10 of 0.9 of SUD minus log to the base 10 of SE, industrial actual component. This will be equal to, what is the EF? EF. This is a log to the log to the base 10 of n minus log to the base 10 of 3. So this will be nothing but only 3. Like this, divided by log to the base of this coordinate 6 and minus 6 minus 3. So this value may be given for you, or this value n is not given for you. N is given, you have to prompt this value known to you from material. Apply interest and we calculate from the KA, KB, KC, that point factor. And this is known to you. Out of this, any one you can calculate the finite life value from this. Make use of this expression to determine the life of the component. So when the component is subjected to the complete reverse stress, and there is a finite life, the life of the is fixed, where SN curve is guideline, and how to draw SN curve we already discussed here. And from this expression, similar to lines AEF and ADB, we have this expression here. So from this expression, life of the component can be calculated. Okay, thanks. Next time we go for the problem.